Hey guys, it's Kevin. Last year, struggled with ET-8550's printhead brackets and the printhead screws. Those are special brackets and screws. If you need it, I'm going to put a link above. You can get it. The installation is a little bit tricky, so Abby today is going to show you how to install them.
Hey guys, it's Abby here. I'm working with an ET-8550 printer, and I'm going to put the brackets back on some dampers and some screws, and I'll show you how to do that. I've already powered on the printer and stopped it back at a station where it'd be easy with me to work with the dampers. I've taken off this cover piece on the left side in the front. There's two screws with it. And now I'm working on taking off this spring. If you take the blue handlebar and you move it towards you, that helps pull the spring towards you to help release it when you pull it off. There's going to be two black screws holding down the tubing and the plastic guard over the tubing. When we take those two screws off, and we'll put it to the side. And in the front by the LCD panel, this is where our waste tank is. And we'll pull off the waste tank, just push it to the left, and it will come off. And this is where we're going to draw the ink from before we lift up on the dampers. That way it doesn't drop all the ink right onto the print head. I'm trying to show you here. You'll see where my finger goes. There's going to be a little nozzle output. It's hard to see in the shadows here, but you'll see it on your printer. I'm using a little suction to draw back any ink that would be in there. Now, our dampers, they are all empty in this case. That's why you see no ink coming through. Now, at that point, we can start unhooking our dampers from the ink tubes, and we can detach them. So here I'm going to go ahead and take off all of the tubing connections to our dampers. And this way we can move that off, because that's where the screws sit under on the dampers. So I'm showing here that there's almost this little pathway on the plastic guard over the tubing. So I took it from under those tabs, the black tabs, and pulled forward to release that tubing. And now we're going to lift up. And you see here, there's two tabs farthest that's holding the tubes down still, so I have to release it from under there. And once I have that, I'm just going to put it out of my way. And here's where all our dampers are. So I need to put brackets on them and then screws as well. Okay, so if anybody's confused in how the dampers go, remember that the top part is a connection to our tubes. That part is going to face towards the back of your carriage, right? And if we're confused about how the bracket goes, the hole in the bracket is going to be where the screw goes, and the screw is in as at the front of the carriage, on top of your printhead, ready? So it's, if we're thinking about that, nozzle connection is in the back, and our hole of the bracket is in the front. So that makes sense. And if we turn it over, our damper over from, we'll call it that, the rough side, the part that we can't see our ink from directly, that's the part where we're going to line up the bracket and try to snap it in. You're going to push, but you also want to make sure that it's lined up. Sometimes you hear it click in, other times it just fits in a little bit, but the way that I test to make sure that it's fully in there is either I'll hear it snap or I won't be able to push it in any farther, but once I do, I should be able to push it back and forth and see the little tail in the back push in and push out like I'm doing here. So that's always my test to make sure that I have the bracket on that damper fully. Now on the back of the carriage, there are tiny little slots. It's too hard to see with the shadows. I was trying to show it, but it's too hard to see. So you'll know when you're putting yours in, but there is a break in the back where there's a slot where that small little tail is going to go in. I used to really suck at putting these brackets and dampers in, but I finally figured out a way to put them in. Go in more towards an angle towards the back, right? If you're holding the damper, hold it up towards an angle as the back is facing at an angle down. And make sure that tail is pushed all the way out towards the back, right? So you're going to push in and then lay it down. And the top part of the bracket where the screw will go, it will sit on top a little bit of the screw hole, you can pull it out a little and then push it back in, and it should fall flat under there, and it looks almost L-shaped once it sits under where the screw goes. So again, let's go through it and then I'll show you better about putting the bracket in. You will definitely see at the front of the bracket, there's only so far that you can go until it will slide in. And then at that point, then it's more of just pushing it in and hearing it click, doing the little test, pushing it back and forth, and going in down at an angle in the back to get your slot in the back first. Once you have your slot in, then you can push down the damper. And here, now do we see, as I was talking about that L shape, the way the L is, you see the black tab a little bit go over onto the bracket, but it's not really that it goes over on top of it. It's more so that the screw, that screw hole will slide more so under that bracket. And that's how you know that it's in there. And it's that same way of taking it out as you would take out that screw and then pull forward on the front part to take that tail out of that slot in the back, right? So here I just sped it up with the last three dampers. Did you see I'm still doing my test? Wiggle it in, go down in the back, and here now I think you'll be able to see what I mean. I pull that forward and then I push it back down. That was a really good example. I had a little bit of trouble just with these screws, just a little bit, but not much. Just make sure you line them up. They weren't as magnetic. They weren't really magnetic, so I couldn't just hope that they would hang on to my screwdriver or my drill. I just had to line them up. That's why you see me doing a little bit of, with the small screwdriver and hand first, lining it up once it gets in, then I use my drill to fully screw it in there. But again, bracket, do my little test to make sure that it's in fully and it wasn't, so I'm pushing it back in and it could. So right, back down at an angle. Now watch the way I pull that screw thing forward and push it under that tab, that black tab. That's how we see how to put them in, okay? I have one more to go and then I'll come back to you. I did not put in this video how to take them out, and maybe I can make another video on showing how to take out the dampers if you would need help with that. But with those brackets again, once you take the screws off, if it's hard, you can stick a little toothpick in there or a dentist pick and pull on the bracket to pull it loose, and then you can lift up that damper if you would like to. That's an easier way. But all right, now we're going to put it back. We're following our steps backwards again. We're just going to put the tubes back over, and I'm going to start connecting all my tubes because that's the first thing I want to remember to do, just so I don't forget accidentally. Make sure that all six dampers are connected to all six tubes, and make sure that they are the correct tubes in the correct order. That way you don't mix up ink to the wrong damper and start printing colors in the wrong spots. That might be something you don't want. And so now I'm just making sure that all my tubing is flat back under any of the tabs that would be holding them down. That way when the printer goes back and forth trying to print, none of the tubes come out and get caught in anything. And that's going to be the same thing with my plastic guarding for the tubes. Is I just want to make sure that there's really no resistance in any of that. And I'll pull the plastic guard as far to the right as I can and slide it under the tabs that they would fit into correctly. Once I have that, then I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put the screws back onto either side of that tubing, and then there'll be one screw on the left and one screw on the right, the two black screws we took out earlier. That's pretty easy to put back in. After that, we will go ahead and get our spring that we took off, and for me, I put the spring on the bottom first. I use that with my fingers. You'll see a little notch down there. And then I use that blue handlebar and I push it back towards me to make putting the spring on easier. This is, I call it a blue handlebar, but I believe it's also like a lock for when you transfer the printer. So yeah, if you move that towards you and move it away from you, it also helps. So Now we're going to put back this top cover where we were working with the printhead. And that requires two black screws as well. And now you can see here that move your printhead back. Keep calling it printhead. Move your carriage back over there just to make sure that everything can work if we were to power it on. Once we put those two screws in, we're going to go ahead and power on the printer just because I want to make sure that everything runs fine. Oh, and don't forget, I almost forgot. I did it in the video, but I almost forgot to tell you, is put your waste tank back in there. That way ink doesn't just spill all inside the printer. So we're powering it on, and looks like it works. So you hope you enjoyed this video. You can visit us at bchtechnologies.com or locally here in Greensboro, North Carolina. So happy printing, everyone.